Hbk Day, and it is, oh wow, September 14th. A quick shout out to Damien, happy birthday. But I just want to go in, and the topic of today is where should I go? And it's been something that's nagging at me because a lot of people around me has been going through the situation, where it be work related, in a relationship, school, financially, at home, you know, just, you know, you feel a little bit of trapped. You feel like you don't know which way to go. And I ask that you listen to me when I go to the trusty Barbie Bible and read from Proverbs 3 verses 5 and 6, which reads as, trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. So I know you understand where I'm going with this. No matter what, God is never going to tell you or stir you in the wrong way. He does ask that you be patient. He does send signs, but usually we keep our eyes closed because you're like, oh, I'm not ready. No. And you're sitting there waiting for that security. You're waiting for that push, that big boulder to hit you after God's been hitting you with so many pebbles, telling you, like, it's getting there, it's getting there, it's getting there. He does not. And understand my, like, just understand right now, God, when your life starts to fall apart, it's just God's way of making everything fall into place. And we as people, we get a little bit rattled and we go crazy because, oh my God, nothing is seeming right. Everything is crashing down on me. But no, if you build something and if you build something wrong, then God, what he does is he's going to try to take it down and build it up as it's supposed to be. He does not want to see you fail. He did not give you life so that you can fail. He gave you life so that you can go through a lot of situations and struggles and excitements and prosperities and successes and things like that, so that you can be the person you are meant to be. Just like an egg, you don't want to be cracked by the pressures of the world. You want to be the yolk inside that develops into the chick that actually cracks the shell of life, and you become what you were meant to be. And you know, you want to be that. You don't want to be what has happened. You want to be what is happening. And a lot of times we get caught up with the what path should I take. And understand this, I got this from my pastor. God is like GPS. You know, when you driving and you don't listen to that person and they're like, make a right 1 mile and things like that, and you keep going the wrong way because you want to take your own things. And even though they will take you a longer distance, they're trying to take you the road less traveled. No one, you know, there's probably less problems and things like that on the path that they're taking, even though it's longer. But we seem to always go the easier way, where has more trouble, and we don't see it. We don't see it, but we gotta understand that God sees everything, and we have to walk by faith and not by sight. And just like a GPS, God, whatever path you decide to take, God doesn't change his mind. He recalculates. And then he reroutes and he gets you back on the same path that you were destined to get on. So no matter what you decide, God will always take you to the right place. So hopefully you got something out of this. If you could hold on to whatever your situation is. If not, then just, take that time to really sit down and think about what's at stake here. Is it your life? Is it your well-being? Is it your spirituality? Is it your finances? What do you have to lose? Till next time, peace, love, and knowledge. Bye.
And what they can't see is your own.